Let me ask you a question. What do you think is healthier when it comes to your heartbeat? A steady heartbeat like a drum? Or a variable heart rate that changes, it's more agile. In fact, it speeds up a little bit when you inhale, and it slows down just a little bit when you exhale. If you answered number two, you would be correct. A healthy heart actually has a high heart rate variability. That means on a beat-to-beat measured level, there's actually quite a bit of difference. If you've never heard about this metric before, you're not alone. Heart rate variability first showed up in the 60s and the 70s when NASA was studying astronauts and using heart rate variability as a metric to try to figure out how they were doing in terms of their health. Today, heart rate variability, as one of many metrics, is used in cardiology, anesthesiology, sports medicine, among others. But here's what happened. With wearable health tech booming, basically millions of people, maybe tens of millions of people, are now waking up and their phone or their watch or some wearable device is telling them their HRV score, and they're wondering, what the heck does that mean? Heart rate variability is an amazing health metric, but if you're confused, you're not alone. That's why I'm making this video. Here's what we'll talk about. Number one, what HRV is. Number two, how to measure it. And friend of the channel, Rob Terhorst, also known as the Quantified Scientist, will be joining us. He does unbiased, unpaid reviews. He's a scientist and he measures all of this stuff in his home lab, and he also does real lab work as well. Number three, I'll share with you my practical use of HRV today and how it might play a role longer term in your life. And lastly, I'll leave you with a guided pre-bed breathing practice that can improve, so increase, your HRV levels, both while you're sleeping and right away when you wake up. My name is Lucas, by the way. I'm a yoga teacher and a teacher trainer. I teach breathing and pranayama extensively, and we've been working with the parasympathetic nervous system and the vagus nerve, of course, and it turns out heart rate variability is very effective at gauging the effectiveness of our practices. So I've been using this stuff for over a decade. Hopefully what I've learned can be helpful for you. Like most of my students and most people, my heart rate variability is the highest, so it's the best, when I'm well rested, when I'm well fed, meaning eating nutritious foods, when I'm managing my stress, and when I haven't overtrained. Now, on the flip side, my heart rate variability was actually the lowest, right in the middle of the COVID pandemic, and I'll tell you more about that later. But first, hit subscribe down below. It helps to support the channel. And number two, in the description down below, click on that link. You'll find a PDF that outlines all the different tech considerations and also will guide you through that breathing practice that I mentioned down below. Okay, let's start off talking about heart rate variability. You have no doubt at some point probably worn one of these. This is a traditional heart rate monitor. It goes across your chest and it's surprisingly accurate. This continues to be the gold standard in terms of heart rate monitoring outside of a clinical setting, and even in a clinical setting, a chest heart rate monitor is very, very reliable. However, what this is measuring is the average. So when you're sitting on the couch and this chest strap or this wearable or whatever device you might be using tells you your heart is beating at 60 beats per minute, that doesn't mean that your heart rate is beating one beat per second. It might be, but unlikely. When you're on the elliptical at the gym and you put your hands on those metal conductors and it's measuring your heart rate and it says you're at 120 beats per minute, that's the average. That doesn't mean that your heartbeat is steady at 2 beats per second. When you're healthy, your heart is agile and it's changing. The changes are not so big that you'd hear it with your ear, but when you measure it using heart rate variability, very, very quickly, you can see it. Here's where things get really challenging. The way you calculate heart rate variability varies between devices. They use different algorithms. Why does any of this matter? Well, I've already shown you two devices. Many of us have multiple devices, and if you start measuring your device to your device, to your phone, to other devices, you'll really quickly think, these things are all contradicting, they're not working, that doesn't work. The second thing you need to understand is that you can't compare your heart rate variability to another person's because it's very unique to your biology. You don't get any useful information. So when you're working with heart rate variability, forget about which formula your device is using. Just focus on using the same device every day. Number two, make sure you only compare you to you, not to your favorite health influencer online. You won't learn anything from that comparison. And number three, make sure you measure your heart rate variability at the same time every day. Most people do it right when they wake up. If you do that, it can be a really helpful tool. However, let me introduce you to Rob Terhorst, the Quantified Scientist. He can share with you more in detail about different tech options with price considerations so that you can make the best choice for you.
Thanks for that introduction, Lucas. I totally agree. It's important to always measure your HRV with this same device, but also at roughly the same time. And I find there are two distinct moments people tend to measure their HRV, either first thing when they're waking up or automatically while they're sleeping. I'd recommend different devices for each of these applications. If you want to measure your HRV first thing in the morning and you want the most reliable measurements, I would use a technology called ECG, or you might know it as EKG, which directly measures the electrical activity of your heart. These usually come in the form of a chest strap, like the one Lucas just showed you, which you would then pair with an app on your phone. This is the most reliable way of measuring your HRV, since ECG gives those nice clean heart rate peaks, which you also see, for instance, when somebody's heart rate is being monitored in the hospital. Now, there are many different types of ECG chest straps, but I personally prefer the H9 and H10 bipolar, which I think is the exact one that Lucas owns. I like it because, one, it's been used and validated in many scientific studies, because it easily connects to your phone, and because the price is not too bad, probably setting you back between $50 and $90. There are different apps to pair the chest straps with, and I personally have good experience with Elite HRV, but there are also others, like for instance HRV for training. Now, instead of measuring your HRV first thing in the morning, you can also measure it automatically throughout the night, which is usually done with a smartwatch, smart band, or smart ring. These don't directly measure electrical signals of the heart, but they use green or red light to measure the changes in blood flow in your arm or finger. This is not quite as reliable as ECG, but often good enough during sleep. Now, there are many devices to choose from, but in my testing, I found, for instance, the Aura ring to be pretty reliable, as you can see in this graph right here, where we are comparing the HRV measurements of the Aura ring to those of the Polar H10, where the better the agreement, the closer the points are to the blue line. Now, it's not perfect, but good enough to observe your trends. The Aura app also has a really nice interface, but it isn't cheap, at $300 for the ring and $5.99 per month for the membership. Somewhat cheaper, I would say, is the Apple Watch, because there's no membership fee, and all Apple Watches tend to have really good heart rate and HRV tracking, and this is even true for the older models. Or if you want to go even cheaper, Fitbit also makes solid smart bands, so check out if one of those in your price category can also measure HRV. Now, Fitbit might not be as good as Apple or Aura, but depending on your needs, it might just be good enough. Oh, and one last thing, you can even use your smartphone to measure your HRV, which has been shown to be relatively accurate. It works very similarly to a smartwatch, but instead of green light, it uses your flashlight, and instead of a light sensor, it uses your camera to detect the light. Performance will vary though between phones, but it might be a good way to get you started with HRV. Check out the apps Wealthery and HRV for training if you're interested. Now, if you want to see more detailed testing of wearables for instance, heart rate, sleep, and GPS, check out my channel, The Quantified Scientist. Now, back to Lucas.
Okay, so now that you understand what heart rate variability is, you understand how to measure it, how do you utilize it in your life? My best suggestion in terms of thinking about HRV in your life is to think about it like calories. When I first learned about calories, I was 19 years old, and it was a revolution for me to learn that one tablespoon of oil compared to one tablespoon of white rice, for example, the oil was so much more calorically dense, so much more nutritionally dense, that was game changing. I spent the better part of 5 months tracking every single thing I ate, and even though I never track calories anymore, that work I did as a 19-year-old really informed and creates a superficial layer of understanding to all the food decisions I make today. I don't ever track my calories, but I know more or less how many calories are in everything that I eat. Heart rate variability is really the same. I spent about the first 6 months with HRV testing my HRV every single day. These days I don't test so much, but when I do, I'm almost certainly right in terms of guessing where I am in my range. So while I don't track calories all the time, calories are super important for my life. While I don't track HRV today, every single day, it still plays a very important role. I just want to give you permission to play around with the tech, create some self-awareness, and then you could always put it to the side if you're not somebody who loves to dive deep into numbers. As I mentioned earlier, my lowest HRV score happened in the height of the COVID pandemic. I got the Delta wave and I didn't really feel that bad. I had a little bit of a fever and was feeling a little achy, but my HRV score was quite literally the lowest I've ever recorded. The reason that's relevant is because until you understand how the data correlates with how you're feeling, you might not understand your feelings as well as you think. I'm not often sick. I'm rarely quite sick. In that case, I had to take time off work and take time off exercise, which almost never happens. And so that was a new learning moment for me. Just wanted to keep that in perspective, because when you're tracking HRV, you might learn that alcohol does you terribly. Or you might learn that if you do a really long run on Saturday, you need 2 days to recover. That type of learning can be very, very informative. Before we jump in with that pre-bed breathing exercise I mentioned, I have a program called YOGABODY Daily. If you're interested in health span and living your best life in the second half, we do strength work, functional strength, and stretching and steps every day. You can learn more about that program at yogabody.com. Now, to prepare for this pre-bed practice, lie down flat in your bed, place your right hand on your heart, your left hand on your abdomen, and I'll guide you through the practice. Lie on your back, place your right hand on your heart, your left hand on your abdomen. We'll breathe in and out through our nose. As you inhale, I'd like your belly to rise to the count of four. As you exhale, your belly falls twice as slow, so to the count of eight. Eyes remain closed, your body relaxes throughout. Let's breathe together. Inhale through your nose, one, two, belly rise, three, four. Exhale through your nose, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rise, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rise, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rises, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rises, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rises, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rises, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rises, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, belly rises, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Final round, inhale, belly rise, one, two, three, four. Exhale, belly falls, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Release your hands at your sides. Eyes remain closed. Now is a good time to drift off to sleep.